Update starts now.
An all-star kind of day. I'm Dave Denholm. NBA's all-star game will get going in New Orleans. 8 p.m. Eastern, 5 p.m. Pacific for the East versus the West. LeBron James and Kyrie Irving, teammates highlighting the East's starting five. And teammates for the West, Kevin Durant and Steph Curry of the Golden State Warriors will lead out the starting five for the Western Conference. Golf, PGA Tour. Dustin Johnson running away and hiding in the Genesis Open at Riviera final round. Johnson made the turn. He's got such a commanding lead. He's 19 under currently, 8 strokes better than 3 golfers in this tournament. Nobody even close on this final round day. NHL Rangers beat the Capitals earlier 2-1. Matt Zuccarello, the game-winning goal in the third period. Rangers have won 7 of 10, 5 straight at home. Here's Zuccarello afterwards.
I think every game in this league, if you win a game, it's you played well. 31 elite teams in this league, you're not on top of your game every night, you're going to end up losing. So I think it's a division game, so obviously it's a big win for us.
One other final already saw the Red Wings topping the Penguins 5-2 despite Sidney Crosby scoring a league-best 32nd goal of the season. Game going on right now. End of the first period. Winnipeg has jumped out on Ottawa 2-0 on the road in that game. College hoop men top 25. All finals. Wisconsin beat Maryland 71-60. The Badgers outscoring the Terps 44-27 in the second half. Butler improved to 10-5 in Big East play with an 82-66 win over DePaul. And also in the Big East, Creighton topped Georgetown, a final of 87-70. NASCAR Joey Logano won the Clash at Daytona. Kyle Busch finished second. That race had been pushed back to today due to inclement weather yesterday. Chase Elliott will make his second straight start from the pole at Daytona 500. Dale Earnhardt Jr. will start second. This is NBC Sports Radio on the NBC Sports Radio mobile app.
Did you know that more than 100,000 people a day are downloading game apps? Mobile apps have become a normal part of everyday lives. Now there's a new exciting sports app that lets you play along with your favorite professional sports team in real time. With this fantastic app, you can predict the next play and even outguess your favorite team members. The more predictions you get correct, the more points you receive. Points can be exchanged for cool prizes, like your favorite jerseys, hats, airline tickets, sports tickets, even a new car. You can play this amazing sports app by yourself, with your friends, or even with a large group of fans from all over the world. This incredible sports app is called FireFan, and it's available right now. Check it out. Sign up today at www.freefirefanapp.com.
This is KCAA.
Join me, Mike Cano, for Mike Cano's Comedy Party, Tuesday, February 21st at the Ontario Improv Comedy Club at the Ontario Mills Mall. Two lucky couples will join me for laughs, dinner, and drinks, plus VIP meet and greet with the comedians. Doors open at 7 p.m. for live music before the show. The show starts at 8. We've got live music, 3 headliners, and tons of free giveaways. It's not just a comedy show, it's a party. See you there.
That's right. Don't forget to join us on Tuesday the 21st. Me, myself, Anthony Biscotti, and the commish. We're going to be at the Ontario Improv for Mike Cano's Comedy Party.
To enter the contest, submit your Valentine theme photo to commishkcaa@gmail.com. commishkcaa@gmail.com. Winners will be announced on Wednesday, February 15th at 8 p.m. on the commish hour. Be creative.
What have I learned so far? I've learned that dropping out of high school was my decision. But as a single mom, that decision affected more than just me. To set an example, I had to be the example. I found a free high school diploma program at Learn for Life that fits around my busy life. I have a team of teachers, tutors, and counselors that really care. I learn at my pace in an environment that is safe and comfortable. What have I learned so far? I've learned that I can change my life.
Are you 14 to 19 years old and looking for a free high school diploma program with flexible meeting times? This program allows you to keep your job or important family responsibilities while earning your high school diploma. If you've fallen behind on credits or dropped out of school completely, get back on track with free tutoring, a caring faculty, and one-on-one attention. For more information on how to reach your graduation goal, visit learnforlife.org. That's LEARN, the number 4, LIFE.org. Or in Enroll today by calling 877-360-LEARN. That's 877-360-LEARN.
For more local radio every day, tune into KCAA Loma Linda.
KCAA 106.5 FM 102.3. This is the Spin Junkie Radio Show.
Get out of that bed, wash your face and hands. Get out of that bed, wash your face and hands. Well, you get in that kitchen, make some noise with the pots and pans. Shining through. Well, you had old dresses, sun comes shining through. I can't believe mine, all of this belongs to you. I believe to the soul you know it now. I believe to the soul you a devil in now. I know. Well,
my heart say go, go. Have a time, cause it's Saturday night now.
Sunday right here in the city of San Bernardino. This is KCAA 106.5 FM. What's happening to everybody out there? I hope everybody is staying dry out there. We love the weather, man. We love the rain. We've been needing it. It's taking us out of the drought. But, man, there's so much of it. There's so much rain that we got going on right now. Be careful out there. I don't know if you guys seen the news, man, but a firefighter truck in the city of San Bernardino had fallen off the freeway, man. It was crazy, right? The weather's crazy. We got some special guests in the house with us today, and we're going to let you guys know about these great events coming up. My man, John Maresca, is in the house, and, of course, the legend, Paul Bahnke, is with us right here, newly inducted into the Boxing Hall of Fame. That's what's up. Clap it up for my man
Thank you, appreciate my man Paul right here.
And we were just talking right now off air, and you got roots here in San Bernardino, right?
Yeah, my grandma was here. I had a Miranda family out here. I grew up out in San Bernardino, but I lived all over California, you know what I'm saying?
Right on, man, right on. Once again, congratulations on that. I see that you were holding a couple bouts. We have a picture that's posted of you on our Facebook, and it's you got three title bouts right there. So you must have been real nice with those monos right there, my man.
Back in the day, it was good. It was good. You know, my first belt was September 13, 1988. Won the Strolls tournament, then on January 9th, 1989, won the WBA American title, but the WBC was April 23rd, 1989, became world champion.
Man, congratulations on that. And then, like I said, inducted to the Hall of Fame. In order to be a Hall of Famer, you have to be really, really skilled at the craft that you take in at any kind of sport if you guys are up on sports, I enjoy boxing. I'm an old school cat. There used to be an old boxing gym right here in the city of San Bernardino, right by the old stadium, and believe it or not, that's kind of where wrestling also got started. Yeah. We used to go there and watch Hulk Hogan, Jimmy Superfly Snuka. Matter of fact, rest in peace to the Superfly Snuka, man, and Roddy Piper, all of them. But a lot of legendary boxers also started their career at amateur fighting right here in the city of San Bernardino.
Right.
You know, the building, it was an old building. It wound up collapsing.
That little old building, right?
Yes, sir, right there by the Recycle Center. Right. It's right here on G Street, I believe it is. But it was one of the spots, man, where they allowed kids to go in. So my uncles and my, you know, everybody would be there, man, watching the bouts and stuff, fight. You know, all the fights.
Right.
But even as a youngster, man, the thing that you guys got going on is Junior Olympics, right?
Right. Junior Olympics coming up.
And that's April 7th through 9th. And we had some of the kids that were here last week with my man Randy Hernandez from R&H Entertainment. And they were letting us know what class they were boxing in and all that. But why don't you guys get into a little bit of that and explain to everybody what the Junior Olympics is all about?
Well, you know, the Junior Olympics is a great thing because when I was coming up in boxing, when you play a sport or play football or any other sport, you might go next town over. As an amateur boxing, when you start, I mean, I went to the next state. At 15 years old, I went to Ohio. At 16 years old, I went to New Zealand. I've been in 12 countries. I mean, just start traveling, the boxing game is great, you know what I'm saying? But the Junior Olympics, it's a good thing. Any sport is good to get, it's a positive to get these kids off the streets, you know, something positive.
That's right. So, that's right. I see you guys also have Warzone Boxing Club from Rialto is one of the, is the ones that are hosting this. It's you could catch them at District Junior Olympics on April 27th. They'll all be there. Warzone, the number there to reach anybody for more information, contact JC at 909-200-0940. And we want to also send a special shout out and thanks to the Junior Olympics chairman, LBC 33, Dominic Cerna, and the president of the LBC 33. And we also got some other boxing events that we want to talk about today. April 15th, man, it's going down. The Rebel T Promotions and Roy Jones Jr. Promotions. You want to get into a little bit of that?
Yeah, it's a big night in Burbank, actually. It's going to be the initial card for Rebel T, which is going to be a really solid promotion. You got to start somewhere. That's the first one. And we're lucky enough to have the people at Roy Jones Jr. really giving us a lot of support. Keith Veltri is over there as the CEO. He's working with Roy Jones. Guy Taylor's his matchmaker. They do a great job, and just they've been nothing but helpful to us. They want to see boxing in California over here, give some local guys some opportunities, and they're providing that. That's all anybody can ever ask is an opportunity, and we're getting that.
Yeah, you know what? Last week, all the kids that were here, a lot of them, they go to practice before school, and like you said, these are all opportunities for a lot of these kids to stay out of trouble and stay out of the streets. And the good thing is that a lot of legendary boxers are actually coming in and supporting all this. you know, before, I don't think it was like that. I think it's because of you know, the whole love of everybody getting back into boxing. We were talking about last week, you know, there's a lot of boxing being shown now on TV. You know, for a while there, it wasn't, you know. But the classic thing about boxing is I like the whole it's like vintage, man. You know what I mean? Yeah. Boxing's like a vintage sport, you know what I'm saying? And to, just to see, like, a nice boxer out there just – you know, moving around, doing his thing, getting his licks in, you know, that comes from a lot of practice, man. That comes from a whole lot of practice. And these young men that were in here, man, you could tell that they're really dedicated to their craft. They do practice, they do school, and then they do practice. Yeah. You know, and during practice, they're doing homework. Yeah. You know, that's a lot of dedication. Yeah.
Keeps
for
you
a
out
youngster
of trouble,
to do, yeah, 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 man.
Keeps you out of trouble.
And for all these youngsters to do, right, right. You know, and man, so you know what, you know, thank you guys for you know, holding ground right there for all those youngsters. But let's talk about your inductee, man, to the Boxing Hall of Fame.
Well, I got blessed. I'm very, very excited. Thank you very much. Rick Ferris inducted me, and I'm honored. I'm honored to be inducted, you know. Just to be with the little Oscars getting inducted the same year. We
nice.
Got a couple other champions getting inducted. I can't name them all because I don't know them all. I don't know who all is getting inducted. No mean Oscars getting inducted. It's just a blessing. Boxing's been good to me. You know, it's an honor to be a, you know, I'm 27 years ago, I was world champion. And I'm not living on that no more. I mean, Facebook, thank God for Facebook. It brings me back up again.
Yeah,
you know?
Yeah.
But it's a blessing for me to be a world champion. No one can ever take that away from me. Like my brother, Sugar Shane Moses, I knew Shane when he was little. De La Hoya, I know all these fighters, Tyson. We're always, even though we're not champions no more, we're still respect world champions.
Well, you know what? You're still champions in the, yeah. in the neighborhoods, man, to all yeah. these kids.
So
that's for sure.
Right.
That's for yep. sure, man. Always a champ, man. Once a champ, always a champ,
right, right,
in my
right,
book.
Right.
You know what I mean? We're going to get into some music right here. Come back and talk more with these great gentlemen. This is some James Brown right here in the JB's. Hey, on a Sunday, the Sunday Squad, it goes down right here every Sunday from 1 to 4 p.m. X-Ray Production, the Whiskey Rambler Show, and this is Ben Junkie Show. My name is Boogie, and we're hanging out with you.
Look here. Someone got a groove like this. You know.
Every Sunday right here, KCAA 106.5. We want to thank our sponsors, Meatless Cafe. 80 years of serving the public right here in the city of San Bernardino. Go and check out the best Mexican food in town. That's right, Meatless Cafe, celebrating 80 years in business. One of the local Latino business owners right there, a big family. Shout out to the Quando family, and shout out to everybody right there at Meatless Cafe. Check them out Tuesday through Sunday. And also, Remedy Bells Bonds. Remedy Bells Bonds, 1-800-BAIL-ME-OUT. If you're ever in any kind of situation, get out my folks right there, and they will help you out. Gil Lemus Insurance in the city of San Bernardino, 1794 North Waterman Avenue. Check him out right there for your auto, home, life, business, and classic car insurance. That's what's going on. 909-882-8700. That's 909-882-8700. Gil Lemus Insurance right there. That's my dude right there. One of my mentors, great guy right there. Real great cat, man. Real great cat. And shout out to everybody else right there at the Marquise. Don't forget, coming up this Wednesday, man, it's going down this Wednesday in the city of San Bernardino, the Marquise, very first comedy night featuring my man Anthony Stone, one of the guests and one of the DJs that was right here at this radio station. Shout out to Anthony Stone, and it'll be hosted by my man Tito Flores. You can catch Tito and them at the Improv in the city of Ontario. Another show, man, going down is my man Beto Cholo Vargas, what is that, Vergara and friends, and my man Eric Blake will be in the Balake. Eric Balake will be in the house right there along with Mike Connell. And also Robert Rodriguez, and hosted by, of course, Beto Cholo. 14th and Mill Street, located in the city of Rancho Cucamonga. 14th and Mill Local Bar and Grill. That is at 11260 4th Street in the city of Rancho Cucamonga. Come and have a good time with us Saturday, May 4th, and that is going down. We got tickets for that, too. And we gave away a bunch of tickets last week, man. We had a lot of callers calling in for that. And we appreciate all you guys showing your love and support. We also want to shout out all our out-of-state listeners, and shout out to all the listeners that support X-Ray Production and the Whiskey Ramblin' Show.
What's up, Rick?
Once again, in the house with us today, the legend right here, boxing champion, newly inducted into the Boxing Hall of Fame, Paul Bahnke, is in the house with us today, along with John Moresca. How do you say that again?
Moresca.
Moresca. John Moresca is in the house with us today. And you guys are working on a book, right?
Yeah, we've been working on it for about 3 months now, I guess, right? We're pretty much done. We've got to come up with the title, and it's the last stage of this right now. But we have got a publisher and everything like that, right, for this to come out. Got a lot of interest in, for the people who don't know Paul's story, I mean, an elite amateur, one fight away from the Olympics. You won 37-7 as an amateur, Paul?
Right.
Okay, then he won a world title. Thing too, you look at his pro record, and people nowadays they see this and say, "What? This is nothing special. Were you 22-7?" So along those lines, and then people don't understand that now he didn't spend, you know, 20 fights in Tijuana knocking out guys in the first round,
right,
padding a record.
Right.
And he'd be 40-7. But if his record was 40-7, would that make him a better fighter because he beat up 20 guys in the first round in TJ? Absolutely not.
You know what I think, man? That inductee right there, and the whole fact that he had three bouts, that says a lot.
Oh no, that's a great fighter that people. He got out of the public eye for a little while. Then he had some troubles after the ring. He's pretty much, in my opinion, come all the way back, and I think he's really in a good spot right now. He's really happy and just enjoying life. Right, Paul?
Life got better for me. Life got better. You know what I'm saying? As we get older, we pass the torch, and things come. We get smarter. We want to get back to the kids, you know? Like my brother JC here, you know what I'm saying? He got a gym going out there, war zone, and what happens is, you see, even though I'm a world champion boxer, these kids that he trains them, They're gonna tell their kids and their grandkids about Jesse. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Because I still talk about my coaches, and I'm telling my kids about my coaches. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
So that right there is a great thing for you. So when you do something positive for the kids,
yeah, he's making a difference in a lot of kids' lives. He might not even realize it now, but later on it'll all come back, and it's all worth it in the long run. I think he knows that already, though.
And that's what's up, man. You guys are also part of, once again, of the Junior Olympics, and that is going down April 7th through April 9th in the city of Paris, California. This is going to be at 18700 Lake Paris Drive.
Actually, they switched the venue on this. It's not.
Oh, they did?
Yeah, it's not confirmed yet. Something happened out of everyone's control, but it's going to be moved to Rancho. More details to come on that one. We'll let everyone know as soon as we know the exact spot on that.
Yeah, keep me posted on that, man, just so we can share that right here. Shout out to Warzone Boxing Gym and also United Boxing Academy. And we also want to shout out SoCal for being one of the sponsors. USA Boxing Committee right there. You can contact JC at 909-200-0940 or contact Al at 818-858-4342. Or Romel at 951-683-9001. All vendors are accepted. For more information, once again, get at those numbers right there. April 7th through April 9th is going down. Hey, we're on a delay right there. Can you hear that?
Yeah.
We're going live right here. We're watching ourselves live. We're watching ourselves watch ourselves watching us. Something like that, right?
It works.
So what else you guys want to cover before we get our next guest in?
Well, I want to talk about Eddie Velez. My business partners would kill me if I didn't mention it. I have a shoe line coming out with Eddie Velez out of Perth Amboy, New Jersey. His nickname is The Shoe. He's had a shoe on Keith Thurman, Zab Judah, Leo Santa Cruz, Chad Dawson, Mauricio Herrera in the past. It's called Kinesi, and it's going to be a top-of-the-line boxing shoe and athletic shoe coming out. So I hope everyone looks out for that. But it's going to be coming around end of April, beginning of May. It'll be available. www.kinesi.shoes.
That's what's up, man. Yes. I want to thank you guys, man. John, thank you for coming through.
Thank you.
Paul, thank you for coming through. You guys are always welcome to come on through and talk about whatever events. You know what I mean?
We
got love for what you guys are doing for the kids and for your guys' locals community, plus the community out here.
Right.
It stretches everywhere. There's boxing everywhere, all over the place. So shout out, you know, I want to shout out Colton Gym, the Hernandez Center, all the boxing gyms here in San Bernardino, the ones out in Rialto, and I believe they have some in the city of Riverside. So shout out to all you coaches out there, man, that work with these kids and put in your time. What you don't know, maybe some of you don't know, is that the coaches don't get paid to do this, man. They do
right.
it because they want to see young men grow into strong, healthy men, and let them know that there's also men out there that care about them.
And we also want to give a shout out to you guys for letting us put the word out there, a positive thing, for letting everybody come out here and put the word out for whatever they're doing. So we thank you guys.
Man, not a problem. This is KCA 106.5 FM. We're going to get into some more music right here. Here we go.
Thank you.
didn't raise no fools, and I should know that, baby, you got it. That's all I can say for you. Got so too much soul, foxy clothes, the cutest nose, a groovy set. There's nothing fake about you, baby, you got it. People can be cruel, they say I've lost my cool. It's very hard to keep my cool when I'm around you, 'cause baby, you got it. That's all I can say for you. Got so too much soul, foxy clothes, the cutest nose, the moodiest shape. There's nothing fake about you, baby, you got it. Now that I found you, gotta cling to you. I'll give you love and money, everything to you. No matter what they say, no matter what I do, I'm never gonna love another girl but you, 'cause the baby you got it. That's all I can say for you. Got so too much soul, foxy clothes, the cutest nose, the newest shape. There's nothing fake about you, baby, you got it. They say no can be, you're not the girl for me, but I see a lot of things in you that they can't see, and baby, you got it. That's all I can say for you. Got so too much soul, baby,
classic Bretton Woods right here on a Sunday. We hope everybody is driving safe out there. Please be really, really careful when you're out on the roads, man. I know it's been raining for a while, and we're supposed to get some more rain tonight. It should already be here hitting us, but we need the rain, so God, thank you for the rain. That's for real right there. And we got some special ladies in the house with us today from the Mosley Camp, Sugar Shane Mosley Camp in the house with us today. How you guys doing today?
Oh, wonderful, good. Wonderful.
Thank you.
Go ahead and introduce you guys yourselves and let everybody know what we got going on.
My name is Serena Mosley, and I am the sister of Sugar Shane Mosley and also the daughter of Jack Mosley, a two-time trainer of the year. We're actually here with Jesse and joining him and partnering with him on the Junior Olympics, which we are very excited about. We got the call, you know, I was very excited to be a part of it because boxing is the Mosley family. My brother started off boxing at 8 years old. I watched him and my father just really train hard, both of them very dedicated, and from all that hard work, he became a champion. And, you know, not just because he's my brother, but, you know, I have to brag on Shane just a little bit. baddest lightweight out there.
Oh, yeah.
If you know Shane Mosley, I mean, those body shots and that jab, I mean, he was very phenomenal. And all that came through dedication, hard work, and them two together was just a phenomenal team. So just thankful to be here with Jesse. We're thankful to be a part of it, and we represent the Pomona Boxing Club, which we're now restructuring because of the city who actually purchased our gym to go ahead and build some new condominiums, which look very nice for the city. But now we're in the process of trying to get our gym back together so we can go ahead and serve the community. So
that's awesome. That's awesome. And let everybody know who you are.
Okay, my name is Shantae Flournoy. I am the pretty much the back office for the Mosley Foundation. I'm pretty much family. I've been knowing Serena since I was 8 years old. We started running track together on the Southern California Cheetahs. So I kind of grew up with the whole family, been there since day one, and very excited that we got a call to assist with the Junior Olympics. And, you know, boxing is our middle name.
That's right. That's right. So the Junior Olympics is April 7th, once again, through the 9th. It's a three-day tournament. And to break down, how does the tournament work? Do you guys know how the tournament works?
Well, I was actually just speaking with Jesse, and the way it's going to work this time is we are going to be hosting the district tournaments, mm-hmm. and then from there,
yeah, you have to go through
the regionals.
Yeah, you have to go through the LBC 33 to go on to the regionals.
And
so, in order to go to the National Junior Olympics, you have to come through the district.
Well, what I'm saying is, like, I know some sports are like it's a single or double elimination type of thing. You know, sometimes like in basketball, you have to play so many games in order to get the winner out of like a playoff or something like that. But with boxing, how does it work on that level?
It's a single elimination.
A single elimination.
Yes.
So if it's one and done, you lose.
Yes.
If you win, you move on to the next
yes.
round. And then from there they go and compete for a spot in the Olympics eventually, right?
Well, they have to go through regionals first.
Right, right. And then
from regionals you go through, like for the local, it's just like Southern California. And then when you go to the regionals, you're dealing with Hawaii, you're dealing with California and New Mexico. And then the top boxers from that go to the national level.
Nice, nice. So they wind up fighting maybe around how many fights, you think?
About eight.
Eight, in order to get a seat on the Olympic team, they would have to win all eight, and then they'd be placed on the Olympic team?
Not necessarily the Olympic team. It's for amateurs is what they call the Junior Olympics.
Right.
Every sport has a Junior Olympics, where you have boxing has a Junior Olympics, you have track and field who has a Junior Olympics. So what it is that all the kids who went through that same process that we're starting now, they all meet at one location nationally, mm-hmm. and then they compete. So it's not really making the Olympic team. It's right. just making it to the National Junior Olympics.
Nice, nice.
But what I can say is when Shane was coming up, of course, you have all ages trying to get to the nationals and the regionals. Yeah. They start off very young. And if they're very good, they start getting a name for themselves, and you have people actually watching them. So as they get older and getting to, I think he was about 16, he was actually on the Junior Olympic team. So wow. he was already there. So once you start, like, if you start at 8 and you're fighting, he, I think, ended up fighting like 250 fights as an amateur. But because he was so good, and Oscar De La Hoya was also on the team, Vernon Forrest, Stevie Johnson, so they were all together, but they started out very young.
Yeah.
And then they keep winning the different nationals, and then the Olympic team will actually start picking them.
Nice, nice. That's real cool, man. That's real cool. We're going to play some more music. Get back right here with these special ladies. This is the Spin Junkie Show. Shout out to DJ Mono and shout out to DJ Dave Cato. Cancer survivors right there. And to all you folks out there that are fighting cancer, we're with you. Especially shout out to my homegirl Sasha up in Northern California who just had some things going on with her. And we just want to say funk cancer all day, every day. We don't like cancer around here. So let's get into some music, man, and bring some light up into here. Here we go.
Gonna break my heart, Mr. Big Stuff. I took my troubles down to Madame Ruth. You know that gypsy with a gold cap tooth. She's got a pad on 34th and Vine, selling little bottles of love potion number 9. I told her that I was a flop with chicks. I've been this way since 1956. She looked at my palm and she made a magic sign. She said, what you need is love potion number 9. She bent down and turned around and gave me a wink. She said, I'm gonna mix it up right here in the sink. It smelled like turpentine and looked like India ink. I held my nose, I closed my eyes.
I took a drink.
I didn't know it was a day or night. I started kissing everything in sight. But when I kissed a cop at 34th and Vine, he broke my little bottle of love potion number 9. And everything in sight. But when I kissed a cop at 34th and Vine, he broke my little bottle of love potion number 9. Love potion number 9.
Classic music right here. Every Sunday it goes down here. We like to play them B-side classics. The True Vinyl. My man DJ Mono is doing the family thing today, or else he would be in the mix with us right here. We also want to shout out everybody at the Marquees. Come and check us out, man. This Wednesday is going down, the first comedy show right there at the Marquees. Free entry, and it's going down. Once again, we have these beautiful ladies with us in the house right here. The Mosley camp is in the pad. And you guys want to talk about some, you guys want to talk about the foundation, and you were saying something about your pops, right?
Yes. Well, I want to shout out to my dad. His name is Jack Mosley, and he is the reason for all of this. He started this legacy. And now that my brother's retired, my nephew, Little Shane, is also coming up. He's a professional fighter right now, so check him out. And just want to shout out to my dad. Thank you so much for all the hard work you've done. I watched you turn Sugar Shane Mosley into an incredible fighter. And Daddy, I just want to thank you because of all the excitement and fun that we had throughout the boxing. It was all because of you. Just want to tell you that I love you and thank you so much. And I promise to do my best to help keep this legacy alive. So, yes, thank you.
That's what's up right there. That's what's up.
And then also would like to talk about our foundation, the Mosley Foundation. We do great things in the community, feeding the homeless. Every Christmas we hand out toys to children that are actually in the hospital. And most of the time their parents are there with other siblings who also get toys as well. Just doing a lot of things in the community. We've hosted many of boxing shows. And once again, I want to thank Jesse for actually presenting us with the opportunity to partner with him, and we're going to do our best to make this one of the best shows ever. So I encourage everybody to just please support, come out, watch the kids. It's very important to them because when they have people there to support them, it shows them that, you know, people do care about them. And a lot of the kids are coming up with no parents, or, you know, just a single mom, and we just want to be there to support them, even if we don't even know them. When we had the gym, we actually helped a lot of unprivileged kids where we actually was partnering with the probation department. And, you know, we did make a difference. You know, we seen kids turn around. So that's what it's all about, you know, giving the love and helping somebody. You know, that's what this life is all about. So
that's right. That's right. And you want to give up all the information on how people can contact you guys?
Yes. We are looking for sponsors for the district Junior Olympics, and we're looking for community sponsors, we're looking for national sponsors, we're looking for business sponsors. So you can contact me. My name is Shantae Flournoy. You can contact me on Facebook. Just look for, actually, it's Shantae Hall on Facebook, or look for Mosley Pomona Boxing Club That's our Facebook. I cannot remember our Twitter, but it'll get all that. But or you can call me at 909-762-7028. We're also looking for vendors for all 4 days. We have some great packages put together, and we just hope that the community comes out and support these kids. Like we always said, the future of boxing starts here, and that's actually with the younger amateurs. So
that's what's up right there. Once again, we want to thank everybody for sliding on through. My man Randy Hernandez for bringing the crew through right here. Don't forget, it's going down April 7th or April 9th. And new location, listen up for the new location. I believe it's going to be in Rancho Cucamonga. The Junior Olympics is going down right there. And also, the comedy spot with my man Beto Cholo, 4th and Mill, local bar and grill, the comedy spot right here in the city of San Bernardino at the Marquis this Wednesday. You're going to get into some more music right here, our very last songs of the evening. Want to thank you guys for tuning in. We know you got different radio stations you can listen to, but we appreciate y'all chilling with us. Now, that's what's happening right here every Sunday, the KCAA Sunday Squad. It goes down from 1 to 4. Let's go. Grazing in the Grass right there, Friends of Distinction, classic music. And if you didn't know, you better ask somebody, man. They just released all of Prince's music on all social medias, all the music sites out there, man. Go and pick that up. Go and check out my man, the symbol, the Prince, the purple one himself, man. Roger, what's up, man? Rest in peace. We're going to get into some of his music right here. This is the Sunday Squad. We'll see you guys next week. Let's go.
KCAA Loma Linda, 1050 AM, 106.5 FM, and now 102.3 FM.
Your NBC Sports Radio update starts now.